Hey guys, my name is Jason. I'm getting cleaned up at the mine and getting stuff down out of here before it snows. But before I do, I wanted to do a quick wash down of the vein, check out some of the structural geology going on that may help answer some questions about how the gold was emplaced and where we can look for some super hot spots in the future. Then I want to take a couple samples down to the rock shop, get them slabbed up, and see if we can find any gold or tellurides in our ore.
The big question for me is how to identify where the hot spots are, where those pockets are. You got the tellurium crystals growing big, you got big gold. That's what I want to figure out, how to identify them and where they are. There's something structurally controlling the mineralization here. I just can't quite figure it out yet. You have that really nice, well-defined hanging wall where the second generation of quartz came through with all the gold and the tellurium. And man, if we can nail down where that gets big and fat, that's where we're going to hit the big, nice pockets of gold. And so what we did here on our drift is our first three or four shots, we just plowed right through that super, super high grade spot right over there. And it all went in the muck. It all went in the bags. So be sure when you're going through those bags to be looking for that tellurium line. And there should be some really, really hot gold samples in there. So I'm going to take a little bit of time here and wash down the vein in a little section of the older stope, kind of right next door to where we're working. But you can see I've done this stuff. The vein shows up really nice. I've got all this stuff over here. It's all just dirty. You can't really see. I'm really interested to see if there's some more high-grade stuff that the old guys left in the face that's been sitting here for 100 years and no one's been able to see it. I'm also looking for vein splits and things like that. We're going to do our best here to show you what I got. I've washed down the vein. We're kind of in a little room here, so I'm just going to pan around and you can see the vein all the way around the room. And it's answered some questions and probably posed quite a bit more. So the vein here is maybe 16, 18, 20 inches, somewhere in there. Kind of swells out going that way. And there's a real nice defined hanging wall. There's a little split right here. I don't know if split's the right word. A secondary emplacement from here down. And then you got wall rock underneath. This is a little bit closer up view of it. So you've got a vein emplacement from here down, and then you've got another emplacement from here up, and there may actually be a third from here to the hanging wall. I'm not sure if this section of quartz came in and split these two. You can tell this lower one has all kinds of wall rock pieces in it, stuff that's entrained in it. I don't see hardly any mineralization in any of it. It's just, I'm assuming it was the first initial rip through a quartz. It ripped through and entrained a bunch of wall rock in it. And then you have this other emplacement here, which is more milky white, but you see these real faint bands of gray. It runs all the way across, right across there. That's that telluride band, and that's where the gold is. The gold hangs out with that telluride band. Now the question is, how do we find that band, and what's it associated with? So in this section, you have a little piece up on the hanging wall that doesn't appear to have the band in it. You have a middle section from here to about here that the band is right up here on the hanging wall of that section, right? You got a real nice defined wall contact here, and the tellurides are in this middle section. The lower section with the entrained wall rock doesn't seem to have much in it. As you come around the corner, you continue to see that those three pieces. You have the section in the middle here that has the gold. There's a nice, well-defined break. The upper section kind of grades into the hanging wall a little bit. It's not very well defined here. And then this secondary bottom section where you actually have a little horse to waste that this quartz was in place. It took some waste. And then you have this the gold-bearing quartz. As you come down, that contact dips pretty steeply, maybe 10, 15 degrees, and then does a little whoop-de-doo and flattens out right down there. We've piled up some of our waste rock in here so you can't see the footwall. But the interesting part to me is there's a transition from nice milky white quartz with tellurides
And then starting right about here, that's gone. And the contact is now fully entrained with all sorts of waste rock, junk, all the way down to the hanging wall. And it seems like our band of tellurides gets pinched out right there. Right there. And so when that goes away, I don't think this vein is running very good. Some of the historical assays kind of show that as well. This section of the vein does not have very much gold values in it. Doesn't have very, very good gold values. But there's something going on right here where it changes dip, or it comes down and flattens out, where the gold goes away. And I'm not sure where it goes, why that happened. It got pinched here somehow. There's another interesting thing right here where this is the top of the waste entrained ore here, I guess what you'd call it. There's some slicks on it, so we can talk about movement here. The vein was moving this way, or this slip was moving this way on its last movement. And now that you're down here, you're starting to see a very well-defined contact between the entrained waste and this other section of vein. You can follow it around the corner right here. But the vein spiders into the hanging wall here, and you're starting to see some sulfides coming out. This has been sitting here for 100 years, so they're all pretty well rusted up. But then look what happens right here. You come around this corner, right at the change of the dip to flat, and you start getting this milky white quartz again. You can see it start to come in right there, and it blooms out right here. See that? How it just pinches right down, whoop, right to nothing. The dip changes, it goes up the hill, and then right up there, it comes back. I don't know if that's in focus up there or not. Right there. That's where it comes back. So you have this, the gold fluids, the rich fluids get pinched out right there, and then they start to bloom out again right here. And as you come across here, you can start to see, right over here is a good spot. You have this gray band of tellurides right there, and there's a little piece of gold right in there. It's too small to worry about. But you've got your values back, and you've got the stuff below you right here, waste rock in it, a little bit of waste here, pieces, a little bit of sulfides in it now. You've got your gold-bearing quartz, and then a contact. You've got some sulfides, and then again, it kind of grades into the hanging wall. The interesting part is, as you come around the corner, our kind of milky white quartz from here, it swells, and then it kind of pinches again, and it pinches right up there. It's about 6 inches wide right here. But as you come around the corner, this is our current drift. As you come around the corner, this 6-inch wide band, all of a sudden, there's kind of the contact. All of a sudden, right in here, boom, you start seeing a bunch of tellurides. See all those gray tellurides? Here's your pay zone right here. Comes around the corner right here. And this is where we started hitting all that super duper high grade. The tellurides band is very, very pronounced now. It's almost continuous across there. And you start seeing nice big gold in the face. Gold, gold. There's a bunch of it through here. I think I've shown you this before. And then right here, the telluride crystals get really, really big. See how big those are? I haven't washed this section down. I got ahead of myself, but I'm so excited. And once you do that, you start getting really, really big, big gold. See that? It's just sticking out of the wall there. I got to come back and make a video of me high grading that. But here's your pay. You've got, it kind of changes character here, which is a little bit interesting. I'll back up so you can see. You've got your telluride band here, and you can trace it all the way across. See that band right there? All the way across, right through there. But what happens is the stuff in the hanging wall and the foot wall, you're starting to get a bunch of sulfides in there. And we've seen that when we were mining, where you get all this pyrrhotite down below. You got quite a bit of sulfides. But I think right there is where the pay is. Let me get it washed down a little bit better, and we'll take a real good look at some of this gold.
So we've got our hanging wall coming across. I peeled off a big piece right here, right off our hanging wall zone. I'm going to go down and slab this thing right across through here, see if we can see if there's gold hanging out right a couple inches under this hanging wall.
We are back down in the rock shop here. I'm super excited to take a couple slabs right across here. It's a little bit too big to fit in my rock saw, so I got to get a hammer and break it right off here so it'll fit. But let's get this guy chucked up. We'll see if we can find any gold right here under this flat contact we saw earlier in the mine. Let's see if I can do this without screwing up the whole thing. There we go. I think that will give us enough clearance. Well, that's a cool rock in itself. Probably slab that guy up as well.
All right, we are all chucked up here in the saw. And again, the theory is this contact, and below it is our high grade pay. So hopefully as we slice down through here somewhere in this zone, actually, I think I see a real nice defined contact there. So somewhere right in here, we're expecting to see gold start coming in on the face of our slabs. Cross your fingers, we'll get it cut up. Here's a look at our first slab. It kind of fell apart. That was expected. But let me get it cleaned up here a little bit. How do we look? There's some good looking stuff down there. Let me index it over about half an inch and we'll take another swath. We're just finished off with our second slab here. Let's see what we got under the hood. Well, they're coming off broken, which is a little bit too bad, but there's some nice looking sulfides there. Let me see if we can find any gold in this stuff. Well, this is just a beautiful piece of Mount Baker lightning quartz, but right down here by my thumb, right there, there's a little piece of gold. So we're starting to get into some visible gold, which is what we were expecting. I haven't seen anything huge yet, but on this side, about an inch away, you're getting gold right here as well. Yellow, there's some over here. So we are definitely in the zone, in the gold zone. Unfortunately, the slabs are breaking apart, so I'm getting two or three pieces that look like this. Hopefully the next slab will stay as one nice piece. But there's definitely gold right under that little slip, that slip line that we were seeing. So we are in the right spot. All right, here's our third slice. And these slabs just won't stay together, which is too bad. Again, we're still in the sulfides. So let me get these pieces here cleaned off, see if we have some more gold. And then we'll do another slice off of there. Well, there wasn't much left exciting in that rock after I slabbed a couple more pieces, but we got that really cool Mount Baker lightning quartz pieces off it. And I think that line, that slip that we're seeing in the vein, right below that 3 or 4 or 5 inches is where that really, really hot stuff is. So stay tuned for a lot more videos. As you can see behind me, I've got a lot of rocks here to cut. I've got some other stuff right over here. This whole table is full of specimens we've been cutting. So be sure to check out these guys on eBay. I've got some really nice pieces of lightning quartz listed right now if you're interested. Thanks everybody for watching, and we'll see you on the next video.